made the German government a final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently this country is at war with Germany.
Our own forces, sweetheart, never win.
Thank you. ladies and gentlemen. Just to put you at your ease, welcome to Flashback, ladies and gentlemen. It's not called Flashback because we keep having flashes at the back. It's called Flashback because we're flashing you back over 50 years of entertainment, hopefully. From Jive to Jive Bunny, from Dame Vera Lynn to Dame Edna, from big bands to Bros. And one of the big bands going in the 1940s, so I'm led to understand, was Glenn Miller, who was keeping everybody in the mood. Not in Germany, though. They banned dancing.
Of course.
Over here, they banned us, but not over here, of course. There was Bally Rambert Company were actually performing down in the 1940s, a long way away. They were travelling around military camps, outlying areas, bringing ballet to the masses. And some of the dancing were put onto films. One of the most notable film was Red Shoes. You may know the story of the Red Shoes, where a young girl is tricked into putting on a pair of red point shoes that were magical and they wouldn't stop dancing, and in the end, she died. In America, the films they were being given in the wars were something to stimulate them and keep their spirits up high. Because, obviously, of the war, and one of the films, Walt Disney used to make a lot of films in those times to keep everyone's spirits up high. Can you see me through the rising smoke? Films like Fantasia and Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, whereby over in this country, ENSA was formed for entertainment for home and abroad. Can you see me yet? Well, I can't see you at all. But you can hear me. You can hear my dulcet tones. ENSA was affectionately known, apparently, by being called every night something awful. Well, I hope it's not tonight. And ENSA's headquarters was in Drury Lane. And in 1946, when the war finished and the theatre opened, Carousel was the first to be staged there, and sometime later it was My Fair Lady, which apparently has been the longest running musical in that theatre's history. And then from after the war, country music took quite a hold because of its topics of dying and separation and lovely topics like that. Well, you know country music, it goes, Ma and Pa is dead, the dog's dying and the wife's left him. Yeah, they must be really pleased with all that. And then along came Elvis Presley and coupled that country music with black soul music and, well, I mean, you know the rest. Things like Jailhouse Rock and the baby boom after the war years. Something happened after the war years. There were a lot of babies born, which led to the big youth culture of the 60s. Very optimistic time, but there were some very negative points too. Some of you may remember where you were when President Kennedy was shot, Martin Luther King, of course, and Vietnam. So, why don't you hold on to your seats, ladies and gentlemen, and we're going to flash you back to the future, if you will, for the last 50 years. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
Thank you.
What do you say to them?
I say, good evening, sir. Excuse me. Can you tell me the time? And suppose he answers me. What do I say?
He won't answer you.
It's getting late. They'll be coming back from the clam bake. I wish he'd come. Suppose he goes.
Here comes. One place for cars while we're waiting.
All right.
Got any money?
80 cents.
All right. 21.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. like John's home.
Leave me alone!
6 months, I could pass her off as a duchess and then with you balls. I could even get her a job as a shop assistant.
What, you, sir?
Yes, you.